Welcome to a new video. This tutorial will show you how to repair the instrument cluster of Mercedes A-Class W169 and B-Class W245 using Minitools Replacement LCD. For this repair, you will need the following tools. Position the dashboard as shown and undo the four rear screws with the Torx screwdriver. With the aid of the Minitools Pry tool, remove the rear cover, then the front one. Position a support under the cluster so that we can lay it without straining the prominent parts on the rear. Fit the gauge face protective discs under the needles and remove them rotating anti-clockwise and gently pulling them. From the rear part of the cluster, undo the clips and release the board. With the curved tip probe, open the FPC connector. Undo the housing of the display from the board. Acting as shown, remove the faulty display. Peel off the rear protective film from the Minitools display. Detach the backlight diffuser from the faulty display and taking the notched corner as a reference, attach it the same way on the rear part of the new display. Peel off the front film as well and carefully fit the display in its housing, as shown. Keeping the display perpendicular to the board, connect the FPC and close the connector. Then reattach the base to the PCB. Carefully follow the following instructions before reassembling the dashboard. Switch on the panel. With a multimeter, measure the voltage between the points indicated and take note of it. If the voltage measured is between 6.95 and 7.05 volts, the problem is solved. Otherwise, to adjust the voltage and the display contrast, it will be necessary to do a modification of the EEPROM 24C04 or 24C32 highlighted in the picture with a specific programmer. Switch off the dashboard and thermally insulate the components around the EEPROM with some Kapton tape. Memorize the EEPROM soldering direction as it has to be soldered back exactly the same way. With a hot air desoldering iron, desolder the EEPROM with the aid of the tweezers. Clip the EEPROM, connecting it to the programmer. Set the reading in hexadecimal and make a backup. Identify on the EEPROM the locations 01BF and 01CF. Scanning the QR code or following the link on the product label, open the PDF with instructions so to use the specific calculation tool to do the modification. To carry out the modification correctly, type in the values related to your defective dashboard. Those used in the video are for illustrative purpose only. Type in the first box on the upper right side the value of the voltage measured before. In this case, the voltage was 8.36 volts. Then, type in its related box the value of the location 01BF, in this case 2B. The tool will automatically calculate the new value, 1C, to insert in the location on the EEPROM. Repeat the operation for the location 01CF, typing in its value in the related box, so to get the new value to insert in the location on the EEPROM. Save the file just modified and upload it on the EEPROM. Unclip the EEPROM from the programmer. Before soldering it back, remove the tin excess from the PCB with the soldering iron with chisel tip and the solder wick. Clean with some solvent. With the tweezers, position the EEPROM on the PCB as it was originally and solder it using a soldering iron with conical tip at 350 degrees. Remove the Kapton tape and clean again with some solvent. Switch on the dashboard again and with the multimeter recheck the voltage between the points indicated before. If, as in this case, the voltage is now between 6.95 and 7.05 volts, the modification was successful. If the voltage has not changed after the EEPROM modification, we recommend contacting us by email at info@minitools.com. Reattach the base with the gauge faces to the PCB. Put back the rear cover, making sure to insert the back part of the reset button properly. Position the needles and, with the Minitools shim, push them at the right level. Then bring them back to their original position. Fit the front cover, tighten the rear screws, switch on the dashboard. Perfetto! Problem solved! Thank you for choosing Minitools.